So if you're having a Raspberry Pi 4 and want to do something interesting, then this video is the one you must watch. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how to install Android TV OS on Raspberry Pi 4 that's going to transform into an Android TV box. Now this way, you can connect the Raspberry Pi 4 to any TV and transform into a powerful Android smart TV that provides an amazing media experience. So without further ado, let's get started. Now for this simple project, you need a Raspberry Pi 4 with at least a 2 GB of RAM or higher, a 16 GB plus class and SD card, mouse and keyboard for controlling the operating system, a decent power adapter, a pen drive of at least a 4 GB plus, HDMI cable to connect to the TV, and lastly, a computer running Windows, Mac OS, or Linux operating system. Now open your favorite browser and head over to these links which I have posted in the description. The first link takes you to the Constacan website. Now from here, you need to download a Lineage OS which is based on Android TV for Raspberry Pi 4. By the time of recording this video, only 2 versions of TV OS are available based on Android 10 and 11. Now for now, I would choose Lineage OS 17.1, which is stable enough to install on Raspberry Pi 4. You can also try the other versions if in case you need to experiment with Raspberry Pi 4. The next up, head over to this website and download the G-Apps, which are required to install Google Play services. Now lastly, head over to this link and download a Balina HR, which can be used to flash Lineage OS to the SD card. Now, once it is done downloading all of the files, place them somewhere on your computer, then go ahead and install Balina HR. Now, go ahead, connect your SD card to the computer, then open Balina HR. Then choose the Select from File option, then look for Lineage OS zip file and import. Now select the target, which is going to be SD card. Now once everything is set, click on Flash to start installing Lineage OS TV Edition on the SD card. Once it's done, eject the SD card. Now connect your pen drive to the computer. Then make sure the pen drive is formatted with FAT32 file system. Now copy a GApps zip file to the pen drive. Once it's done, eject the pen drive and place it somewhere which is required in step number 4. Now once everything is set, go ahead, insert the SD card, connect the Raspberry Pi 4 to the TV using an HDMI cable, using an Ethernet cable for internet connection. You can also use Wi-Fi, but I prefer to choose an Ethernet for now. Now in this video, I'm going to use a wireless keyboard and mouse to control TV OS. Now, lastly, connect the power cord and turn on the Raspberry Pi 4. The first bit will take around 2 to 5 minutes, so sit back and relax and don't interrupt anything. Alright, so as you can see, Raspberry Pi 4 has been booted into TV OS successfully. So let me go ahead and set up the welcome screen of Lineage OS. Since we are using a keyboard, you need to remember these shortcuts, which is very important to control the TV OS. Now these are the function keys that can be used a lot. The F1 key to go to the home screen and the F2 for back. Now pressing and holding F5 for the power menu. Now just remember these keys. If in case you see a Bluetooth is searching for accessories on the first boot, now just press F2 to go back and continue this setup. You can use a mouse cursor to finish the welcome screen setup. Now this is the basic Android TV launcher you will see over the welcome screen. Now as you can see, there are no applications have installed. Now we're going to fix that issue by flashing the GApps package from the pen drive. Anyway, use the keyboard or mouse to navigate the user interface and select the app gear icon on the top left. Now from the app drawer, choose Files application and open. Now go ahead, connect the pen drive to the Raspberry Pi 4 and copy the G apps to the internal storage of the Raspberry Pi 4. Now once it's done copying, go back to the main home screen by pressing the F2 key on the keyboard. Now open the main settings, then choose device preferences, then select the about page and tap on the build number 7 times to activate the developer settings. Now go back and look for the developer settings. Now inside here, enable the advanced reboot. Now once it's done, go back and select the Raspberry Pi settings. Now I'm going to leave everything as default and come to the overclock section and increase the CPU frequency to 2000 MHz. Now keep in mind, overclocking a Raspberry Pi 4 needs a proper CPU cooler installed, and a high watt power adapter is required to make it work as intended. Now once it's done, go back and choose the About page. Then click on Restart, and this time boot the Raspberry Pi 4 into a recovery mode. Now inside the recovery mode, go ahead and swipe to allow the modifications. Now keep in mind, you need to rely on the mouse with an ATWRP and the keyboard functionality is disabled. Now choose the install option and look for the zip file and flash. Now this is going to install the Google applications, Play Store and Play services. Now once it's done flashing, reboot the Raspberry Pi 4 to the system. Now after booting, your Raspberry Pi 4 will be searching for an IR remote. Go ahead, press the back button a couple of times to go back to the Android TV welcome screen. Now set the language, sign in with your Google account to finish the setup screen. Alright, now you can see TV OS and all of the applications on the home screen. There is a YouTube, Play Movies, Prime Video and more. For now, let's see how YouTube performs. I'm gonna play a 1080p video from my channel and see how it works. Use it as my secondary smartphone for the next couple of months. But the moment I bought the OnePlus 9, I heard the announcement from OnePlus that they are going to merge Oxygen OS with the color of numerous bugs, heating and performance issues. Now due to a lot of headaches in regards to Oxygen OS, Now as you can see, the video playback was super smooth, no frame drops have been encountered, it handles everything intact. As of now, unfortunately, you cannot play a 4K video at the moment, which is sort of bummer. Also, there is a Google Play Store, which you can use it to download a TV applications like Spotify, Twitch, and more. Now, lastly, if you notice, there is an issue with the SD card and the TV OS is not using the full space of the SD card. As you can see, it's restricted to using a 5GB of internal storage and the rest of the free space is treated as unallocated. So I'm using the 32GB of SD card and around a 23GB of free space is not at all getting used by the operating system. So to fix this issue, turn on the Raspberry Pi 4. eject the SD card and connect to the computer running any Linux-based operating system. Now I'm going to use a tool called a gparted. Now inside the gparted application, select your SD card from the drop-down menu on the top right. Then it's going to list all the partitions of the SD card. Now as you can see, user data is using only 5 GB. Now go ahead, right-click on the user data block and choose to resize and expand the unallocated free space to the maximum. Now once it's done, apply the changes. And that's it, insert the SD card back at the Raspberry Pi 4. Now this time, the internal storage has been extended to the maximum. And that's pretty much it. This is how you turn your Raspberry Pi 4 into an Android TV box. It runs super smooth without any issues. You can play games and do more. Now if in case you like this video, hit the thumbs up button down there and don't forget to subscribe to this channel and consider hitting the bell icon to receive the post notification. Thanks for watching this video. This has been KSKRL. I will see you in my next one. Peace.